A few months ago, I've been given this tool by a family member. He told me that this was a measuring device that was given to him probably more than 30 years ago. Unfortunately, he was never able to use it because he never understood how it worked. It seems that there is a ring inside, but when we try to measure it, we never get a measurement that makes sense. So let's open the box and take a look inside. This is an internal micrometer, and that means this is capable of measuring the diameter of a hole, or bore size. This specific unit is able to measure from 25 to 37 millimeters, depending on the legs on this end. With this set of legs, we can measure from 25 to 31 millimeters, but with this set of legs, we can measure from 31 to 37 millimeters. So every time we need to swap the set of legs, we need to recalibrate the micrometer. And for that, we use this calibration ring. Now let me show you the condition of this micrometer and why the previous owner, who didn't know this needed calibration, was never able to use it. So right now we have the little legs fitted. And we should go on this side of the scale to 31 millimeters, and that should be a tight fit in the ring. And we're right about 31. So let's see how this fits. And as you can see, it's very, very loose. We're still loose. And that's about it. So we're way, way past 31. So what we need to do now is to take this apart, try to understand how this works, and try to calibrate it. In the box, there was a set of instructions, sticky instructions, but they are for extensions, which are not suitable for this model. So these will not help much. This looks like a ratchet thimble, but it's stuck. I don't know. Okay. Okay, so this acts like a piston and pushes these little legs. The threads have some witness marks close to the screws, so someone had a big screwdriver here when changing these pieces. Okay. Now for the body. These are pretty small set screws. Maybe 1 millimeter. I don't know if I have an Allen key for this. We can get away with a T5 Torx bit. So I've been messing with this for a little while now, and this wasn't press fitted. So basically there's a set screw in here that goes through this side of the thread and then goes through the hole and sets on the other side. This is how this is locked. If we remove the set screw, and it just fell off, we can undo this barrel. So what I'll do now is get these parts cleaned and get them ready for assembly. So I got the first half of the micrometer cleaned, including these two set of legs or anvils, and I didn't find a way to calibrate these yet. So I'm guessing the calibration should be done with this part. There's a thread in here, and I think there's a nut at the end which allows the adjustment to be done. So let's take this apart and see if that's true or not. Oh, there's a spring. Oh, so this is a ratcheting thimble. Okay. So I don't know why this was stuck. Yeah. Okay. Oh, so that's how the calibration is done. We move this little nut and this acts like a stop. Let's get this clean and move on with the assembly and calibration. But first, let me show you something. So we have a little bit of backlash in this. So I'm not sure if it's audible. So what we need to do is tighten this nut in order to remove that backlash. Yeah, we need a set of pliers. Wow, much better. The parts from the second half of the micrometer are now cleaned. I mostly used brake cleaner to degrease everything. And for the knurl knob, I used this brush. So let's put this back together.
I don't think we should use oil in micrometers, but I think I'll add one drop in the spindle thread. This is very fine machine oil. And now I'll wipe off the excess. Now for the calibration procedure, what I'll do is bring up this nut to the top, because this dial will need to be clamped against the nut. Now I'll add the ratchet mechanism, and that will ensure that we always use the same amount of pressure when we make a measurement. So to clamp this, we need to lock the spindle. And then lock the thimble. Okay, so we now unlock the spindle again. And we use the calibration ring to expand the anvils until the ratchet clicks. Okay, now we know that we are at 30.997 millimeters. And what I'll do is to lock the spindle again. Okay, so now what we need to do is to make the reading match what we know. And we know that we are on 30.997. Okay, so now we take apart the thimble again and we adjust the nut until our measurement is correct. Okay, now we unlock the spindle again. We now can fit this guard. And now with the tool complete, we can check one last time to ensure everything is all right. And it's perfect. So this is how you can calibrate an internal micrometer like this. I hope this might be useful for someone out there, and hope to see you on the next one. Bye everyone.